Hello doctors, after the completion of biomechanics sternoclavicular joint, next moves into the acromioclavicular joint. In this, the type of joint is plain synovial joint, as there are three rotational and three translation motions. You are articulating surfaces that we need to write the basic concept of anatomy before writing the biomechanics of any joint. In this, lateral end of the clavicle and small facet on the acromion process of scapula is the articulating surfaces, and the disc, it will be changing or vary from the one person to the other person, and it has 2 years fibrocartilage getting united, and the meniscoid fibrocartilage will be the remnant within the joint, and the capsule for this acromioclavicular joint, it will be loose fibrous layer encloses the two articular surfaces and limited and internally covered by the synovial membrane, and the upper part of your capsule, it will be thickened, forming the acromioclavicular ligament. Next, the ligaments most are your superior inferior acromioclavicular ligaments. It means these fibers getting attached to the trapezius and deltoid muscle. Your superiorly acromioclavicular ligament will have forcing in the anteriorly, pulling in anteriorly, and coracoclavicular ligament divided into two, that is medial coracoclavicular ligament and lateral coracoclavicular ligament, as there are two shapes showing. Your medial coracoclavicular ligament will be in triangular and the lateral coracoclavicular ligament will be in quadrilateral angle. In medial, there will be conoid part and superior directed forces. In lateral side, there will be in trapezoid part and the posterior directed forces, as these both will be in translatory motion, one over the other. And if a person waiting on his arms, then the humerus bone forcing in medially, and the weight will be transferred on the scapula, glenoid fossa, then clavicle, and reaches into the coracoclavicular ligament. So these are the points you can cover in this acromioclavicular joint. Next comes under the motions. Your upward and downward rotations, it will be in AP axis, perpendicular to the plane of your scapula. Your upward rotation will tilting the glenoid fossa upwardly, acromioclavicular ligament, your conoid and the superior ball of the clavicle, and it reaches the range of motion passively 30 degrees. And downward rotation, it will be exact opposite to the upward rotation. An internal or external rotations takes place in vertical axis. Rotations can maintain a contact to the scapula with the horizontal curvature of thorax, as clavicle will be protract and retracts. It means it slides the scapula around thorax, reaching about 40 to 60 degrees of range of motion. Next comes your anterior posterior tilting. At the coronal axis related to the clavicle, anterior tilting will be acromion tilting. It means at the side of your acromion process of the bone for reaching the forward, and the inferior angle to the scapula, that will be backward, and your action is about shrugging of your shoulders in elevation. Next, it posterior tilting. You can see the acromion tilting, it tilts at the backward, and the inferior tilting will forward at the range of your motion 60 degrees. So you can write in these steps. So very, very most simplified in the my notes giving to you. And you can draw the diagram in these rotations, upward, downward, internal, external rotations, and your tilting. And the most, the stress, it may leads into the when you fall, and also causes the degenerative changes when you fall on the shoulder, your shoulder will be getting your adductor and leads to the sprain. That is your ligament tearing up and subluxation. It means subluxation, it means nothing but your bone will be in some alignment and it has some little about the little fracture and it lies in the same alignment. This shows the subluxation of your joint. Total about biomechanics, your acromioclavicular joint, very much important. Next comes into the scapulothoracic joint. Has the joint connects between your scapula and thorax. It is not a true anatomic joint, and the articulation between the scapula with thorax has the sternoclavicular and acromioclavicular or independent or interdependent on the scapulothoracic motion, because scapula will be getting attached to its acromion bone and the lateral end of the clavicle through the AC joint. And when the scapula thoracic will be in resting conditions, you can see from the superior view, anterior to the coronal plane, and side view you can see vertical plane. Your motions, primary it will be an upward rotations, and secondary your internal external rotations and your tilting. If the scapula thoracic will be in upward rotation, and when you are elevating your arm, there will be increased range of motion over your head activities, and the upward rotation of your scapula will be produced by your elevation of your AC, rotation of your AC joint. When comes under your internal external rotations, and it will be accompanying your protraction retraction of your clavicle of your AC joint, and internal rotation of your scapula produced on the thorax will occur only on the AC joint, and there will be a prominence of this medial border. Has the prominence of medial border because of these rotations, your scapula will be swinging, that is your dancing like. And anterior posterior tilting takes at the AC joint, and with this anterior tilted will be elevation of your arm. So your inferior angle of scapula, it means it will be at lifting off from the thorax, and it shows some of the prominent. And elevation depression, shrugging the shoulders up, and depression the shoulders down. It runs in the transitory motion. Elevation depression of the scapula are produced by the elevation depression of the clavicle at AC joints and by rotations at the AC joint. These all the most easily simplified notes. You can write these notes also in exam. And protraction retraction, it takes in translatory motion, but your scapula will be abducted and adducted. Protraction retraction of your scapula are produced by the protraction retraction of the clavicle at AC joint and by the rotations at the AC joint. And you can see in this picture your elevation, depression, clavicular, AC joint rotations, and these all about the scapulothoracic joint. And it is not a true anatomic joint. It takes place with the two joints. Those are your SC and AC joints. In remaining video, we will deal with the glenohumeral joint. Thanks for watching and show some support to my channel. Thanks for watching.